And we will try to remember the difference between formal and informal language, especially when we use this kind of language, when we write emails. So we're gonna make a listening and a reading exercise. We obviously will have our classwork and we are going to start right now. So who can tell me, how do you know or how can you differentiate a formal email from an informal email? What's formal, or how do you know that an email is formal? ¿Cómo sabemos que un email es formal, chicos? How do you realize that it's a formal email?
There, Mr. Bolaños, y en informal language decimos, hi, Daniel.
Exactly, we're going to use some formulas at the beginning, right? For example, dear, Mr., maybe Mrs., right? So from the beginning, it's going to be something different in both of them. And in an informal email, Daniel told us that we usually say, hi, or we greet like hey. So here we have a small difference, right? Is there something else you notice that it's different from both of these emails? ¿Hay alguna otra diferencia entre estos dos mails?
There is.
Can you repeat again, please?
Redaction, la redacción.
Uh-huh. What happened with the writing part? ¿Qué es diferente en la redacción, Edith?
La manera que se usa el lenguaje, digamos que recibo, en el formal recibo un cordial saludo, mientras que en el otro, hola, ¿cómo estás?
Mm-hmm, exactly.
Espero te encuentres bien.
Perfect. The way you start the email, it's going to be different, right? Like, hey, how are you doing? What you been up to, right? Como que, ¿qué más? ¿Qué has hecho? Right? And as Edith told us, you are going to use a very polite language, right? For example, regarding to the last email. ¿Verdad? De acuerdo con el último email. Or answering the previous email. So you're going to use some formal words, or you are going to use a formal language in this case, right? What happened then at the end? ¿Qué pasa luego al final? ¿Cuál es la diferencia cuando nos despedimos en un mail formal y en un informal email. O en todos se despiden ustedes igual. What's the difference between both? Can you remember? Can you remember the way you end an email? Elvis, how do you end an email?
Este teacher, en la informal solo se dice goodbye. Por ejemplo, en la formal era un mensaje como decir... Desear buenos deseos, algo así era, no recuerdo bien bien.
Okay. We are going to use something different, right? In the formal email, you're going to use something like best regards, right? Maybe regards, maybe yours faithfully. Equivaldría, ¿no?, a cuando uno se despide muy atentamente, bla, 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 y luego el nombre, ¿verdad? But in an informal email, you have different kinds or types of words you can use when you want to say goodbye. As Elvis said, we can say goodbye, right? Bye-bye. We can say love, we can say some farewells that are very informal, right? Son básicamente despedidas que son muy cortas, muy de confianza, ¿no? Con amor. Chao, nos vemos. Esa sería la forma en la que básicamente nos despedimos en un informal email or in an informal language. Something that we can see it's different also, it's this. What happened with formal emails? This is very important and this is a clue. Sí, es una pista, algo muy importante que hay que tener en cuenta. Cuando ustedes van a escribir un mail formal, es una obligación, it's a must, algo que no debe ocurrir nunca. Sí, en el formal email, you're never going to use any contraction. Sí, no se admiten contracciones. This is very important to remember when you are writing a formal mail. ¿Sí? En un mail formal es muy, muy importante recordar esto. No se admite ningún tipo de contracciones. But in a new formal email, we can make all the contractions we want. ¿Sí? En este caso, en el mail informal, cuando es algo más de confianza, sí podemos ocupar contracciones. Okay, so when you are writing to a friend, you can use, for example, don't, ¿verdad? Podemos ocupar el don't, podríamos ocupar otra contracción muy común que es you're, ¿no es cierto? You are. And so on. So all the contractions are allowed. When we don't want to make a contraction, we're going to use the full form. Y cuando no podemos utilizar las contracciones, ocupamos las formas reales, las formas completas de esas palabras. For example, over here we can say do not. ¿Cuál sería, por ejemplo, you are there is, you know, poner there's or something like that, okay? So you're going to use the full form of the words. Utilizamos forma completa de las palabras, ¿no? So here we have some of the different differences between both formal and informal emails. So you have an idea of what are we going to do today and what are we going to talk today. Okay, so pay attention, guys, because now we're going to listen a short record of three people talking. Sí, vamos a escuchar un audio de tres personas hablando. And I'm going to ask you to help me completing some questions, okay? So let me erase this and share the screen with you. As you can see here on the screen, here we have six questions. There's gonna be two questions for each person we listen. And as you know, we're gonna listen to three people. So we have six questions right here. Can you help me reading the questions, please? Help me reading question number one, please, Adrián. Ayúdame leyendo la pregunta número uno, por favor.
Okay, teacher. What did Tim want to ask the shop assistant?
What did Tim want to ask to the shop assistant? No, ¿qué quería preguntar Tim a las vendedoras? Let's see, question number two. Can you help me reading, please, this time? Odalis?
Yeah, teacher. What did he do when the shop assistant didn't help him?
Exactly. ¿Qué hizo cuando las vendedoras no le ayudaron? Okay, so pay attention to this information on the listening. Vamos a prestar mucha atención a esta información en el listening que vamos a escuchar. Here we have the next question. Sí, esas dos preguntas están relacionadas con Tim. Vamos a ver las preguntas de Vicky. Lizette, can you help me reading number three, please?
Okay, teacher. What would Vicky do if she was the manager of a company?
Exactly. En la parte de Vicky nos vamos a enfocar en esto. ¿Qué haría Vicky si ella fuese la manager? Okay. Let's see number four. Jody, can you help me reading number four, please?
What does she say she won't do in the future?
Exactly. What does she say she won't do in the future? ¿Sí? ¿Qué es lo que ella dice que no haría en el futuro? Ok, esas serían las dos preguntas en las que nos vamos a enfocar cuando escuchemos a Vicky hablar. Ok, let's move to Rebecca. Can you help me reading question number five, please, Sebas?
Yes, teacher. Why did Rebecca want people to reply to her invitation?
Exactly. Why did Rebecca want people to reply to her invitation? ¿Sí? ¿Por qué quería Rebecca que la gente le conteste a su invitación? Okay, and let's see the last question we have. Can you help me reading, please? Alison Andrade, can you help me reading number six, please?
Yes, teacher. Why did she feel embarrassed at her party?
Exactly. Why did she feel embarrassed at her party? ¿Por qué se sintió avergonzada en su propia fiesta? Okay, so we know what are we looking for in the record, right? Ya sabemos qué es lo que estamos buscando, cuáles son las preguntas que necesitamos responder en el siguiente audio. So, as I told you previously, we're going to listen to three people talking. Sí, vamos a escuchar a tres personas hablando. Tim, Becky, and Rebecca. So, let's listen, guys, and help me with the answers for these six questions. Ayúdenme con la respuesta de estas seis preguntas. Okay, I'm going to ask you in a random way. Les voy a preguntar estas respuestas de forma aleatoria. Okay, everybody, pay attention.
Track 3.33. Tim.
I went to buy a new pair of jeans the other day. I was the only customer in the shop, and there were two shop assistants. They were chatting about what they did at the weekend. And when I asked for assistance, they just carried on talking. It was so rude. All I wanted to know was the price of some jeans. In the end, I decided to just leave the shop. I don't think they even noticed I was there. I felt like writing an email to the shop manager to complain. But then I forgot to.
Okay, let's listen again, Tim's part, so you can help me with the answers. Okay, vamos a escuchar nuevamente a Tim para que me ayuden con las respuestas. Remember, what did Tim want to ask to the shop assistants? And what did he do when the shop assistants didn't help him? Okay, so listen again, please.
I went to buy a new pair of jeans the other day. I was the only customer in the shop, and there were two shop assistants. They were chatting about what they did at the weekend. And when I asked for assistance, they just carried on talking. It was so rude. All I wanted to know was the price of some jeans. In the end, I decided to just leave the shop. I don't think they even noticed I was there. I felt like writing an email to the shop manager to complain. But then I forgot to.
Okay, can you help me please, Pame Utreras? What did Tim want to ask to the shop assistants? ¿Qué quería preguntar Tim?
If I could change the jean in another size?
Not about the size, but you have the idea. He was asking about a jean, right? A pair of jeans. Iba a preguntar algo sobre unos jeans. No la talla, sino algo más. What was it? Adrián.
The price of the jeans.
The price of the jeans, exactly. The price of the jeans. He wanted to know how much did they cost. Good. What happened with not question number two? What did he do when he didn't feel good in the shop? ¿Qué hizo cuando no le ayudaron en la tienda? Tienda. Can you help me with the answer, please, Emory?
He left the shop.
Exactly. He left the shop. Perfect. He said, I leave. ¿Verdad? Él nos decía en presente. En este caso, Emory nos está dando la respuesta en pasado, pero está muy bien. It's right, definitely right. He left the shop. Él se fue de la tienda, ¿no? He said, they probably didn't realize I was there. Sí, ahí decía en el audio, a lo mejor ni siquiera se dieron cuenta que yo estaba ahí. Okay. So, let's see. Vicky's participation. Vamos a escuchar ahora a una chica, Vicky. Y ustedes me van a ayudar con estas dos preguntas. What would Vicky do if she was the manager of the company? ¿Qué haría Vicky si ella fuera la manager, la gerente de esa compañía? ¿Y what does she say she won't do in the future? ¿Y qué es lo que no va a hacer ella en el futuro? Okay. Pay attention, everybody.
Vicky.
One thing that I think is rude is when shops or companies don't reply when someone makes a complaint. I remember once I bought an MP3 player online. It took ages to arrive, like about a month. So I wrote an email to complain, but I didn't hear anything from them. I mean, is it too hard just to send an email saying sorry? If I were the manager of a company, I'd make sure I replied to every customer. I know it's not easy to run a business, but if you want to keep your customers happy, you should answer their emails. Well, I won't use that company again. I'll go to a local shop instead.
Rebecca.
Okay, let's listen, Becky, again. Vamos a escuchar nuevamente a Becky. Acuérdense, ¿qué haría Becky si ella fuese la manager de la compañía? Pay attention.
Vicky.
One thing that I think is rude is when shops or companies don't reply when someone makes a complaint. I remember once I bought an MP3 player online. It took ages to arrive, like about a month. So I wrote an email to complain, but I didn't hear anything from them. I mean, is it too hard just to send an email saying sorry? If I were the manager of a company, I'd make sure I replied to every customer. I know it's not easy to run a business, but if you want to keep your customers happy, you should answer their emails. Well, I won't use that company again. I'll go to a local shop instead.
Okay, guys. So what would Vicky do if she was the manager of the company? ¿Qué haría si ella fuese la manager de la empresa? Can you help me with the answer, please, Daniel Garcés?
Yes, teacher. She will make sure to reply all the emails.
Exactly. She would reply. So let me write it over here. She would reply. To every single customer message, right? She was saying, ella nos decía que si ella fuese gerente, ella se encargaría o se aseguraría de responder los mails de todos los clientes, right? What about the future? What she won't do in the future? ¿Qué es lo que ella ya no va a hacer en el futuro? Did you listen that information, please? Let me see. Carolina? Question number 4.
She won't use the company again.
Exactly. She won't buy or she won't use the company again. Exactly. Ya no va a volver a comprar ahí nunca más, ¿no es cierto? En una empresa en la que se demoraron en entregarle el producto y aparte no le respondieron la queja. That's something that pisses some people off, right? Algo que molesta a muchas personas puede ser eso exactamente, que no contesten cuando alguien hace un reclamo, for example. So, let's listen to Rebecca, guys. Vamos ya al último caso. Vamos a escuchar a Rebecca and please pay attention to these two questions, number 5 and number 6, please. Pay attention, everybody.
Rebecca. Look, if I invited you to my party, you'd let me know if you could come or not, wouldn't you? You'd think so. But last month I had a party and invited about 40 people, and about half of them didn't say if they were coming or not. Most of them didn't come in the end, and in my invitation, I did ask them to let me know. I think that kind of behaviour is incredibly rude, don't you? I mean, I needed to know how many people were coming, so I had enough food and drink. But then I made too much food and it was embarrassing. All they needed to do was send a text or email, which is not very difficult. There are some people I invited to that party who I'll never get in touch with again.
Okay, let's listen again. Vamos a escuchar nuevamente la parte de Rebecca. Okay, let me see.
Look, if I invited you to my party, you'd let me know if you could come or not, wouldn't you? You'd think so. But last month I had a party and invited about 40 people, and about half of them didn't say if they were coming or not. Most of them didn't come in the end, and in my invitation, I did ask them to let me know. I think that kind of behaviour is incredibly rude, don't you? I mean, I needed to know how many people were coming, so I had enough food and drink. But then I made too much food and it was embarrassing. All they needed to do was send a text or email, which is not very difficult. There are some people I invited to that party who I'll never get in touch with again.
Okay, guys. So let's see the answer of number 5. We have, why Rebecca want people to reply to her invitation? Edgar, do you know the answer of number 5?
Yes, I think to make the drinks.
Okay, to make the drinks. What else? To make or to buy what? Antonio Ortiz, what else did Rebecca wanted to buy for the party? ¿Y nos hace falta algo? Exactly. Thank you, Edith. So she wanted to be sure about the food and drinks, right? Quería estar ella segura de la cantidad de comida y de bebidas para la fiesta. Now, what happened at the end? Why she feel, did she feel embarrassed at the party? ¿Por qué le dio penita o le dio un poco de vergüenza en la fiesta? Maybe Daniel Bolaños, did you listen the last part?
Yes, teacher. She feel embarrassed because she don't have food or drinks for another invitees.
Okay, maybe because she didn't have enough food. What do you think? Do you agree? De acuerdo todo. Yeah.
¿Cómo?
¿Tenía o no tenía mucha comida?
No, no tenía. Por eso estaba bien.
Okay, Daniel says she didn't have. What do you think?
Maybe too much food?
Too much food, tell us, Adrián. Good. Pay attention, guys, to this part.
I mean, I needed to know how many people were coming, so I had enough food and drink. But then I made too much food, and it was...
I made too much food. No, I can use this. I made too much food, and that was embarrassing. Sí, hice demasiada comida. She made too much food. So she felt embarrassed, right? Se sintió avergonzada porque hizo demasiada comida en cambio. Okay, guys. So as you can see here, you did a good job with the listening this time. We are getting better. Van mejorando en la parte de listening. Al menos esta vez hicimos únicamente dos. We played the record twice and you got the answers right away. So, think about something similar. So you hear three different situations, right? And the first one, the guy wasn't received in a good way in a shop. In the second one, Vicky also have a problem with the company who didn't answer her messages. And at the end, Rebecca didn't get all the replies for her invitation. So think about an experience you had where you felt someone else's behavior was rude. Sí, acuérdense de aquella vez en la que alguien más fue grosero con ustedes. Sí, when was that time? Sí, what was that experience? What happened? So, I'm going to start sharing with you an experience. Sí, voy a empezar yo. To give you an example, I remember that last year, one of the courses I have, they had to buy the book and get the code and so on. So they had to activate this Cambridge platform, and almost all the students did so, but there were a few who didn't. And I asked the students to please join and activate the Cambridge book and so on. But there was a student who told me, teacher, I have a problem. The thing is that the company gave me the wrong code. Okay, so I told this student to write to the company and ask for the right code. The thing is that the student didn't check the number and he thought that he was writing to the company, and instead he was writing me. So he was very rude. He said that he wanted his money back and things like that. And I was like, I don't work there. I just work for the university. And he was like, no, you have to solve the problem and blah, 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 blah. And at the end, he realized that he was talking to the teacher, not to the company. And he felt so embarrassed, but he was very rude with me. So here you have an example of an experience when someone else was rude. Sí, aquí les dejo ya el ejemplo de cuando alguien más ha sido grosero conmigo, sí, sin darse cuenta en realidad, ¿no? A veces no nos fijamos en los números y escribimos a otra persona y pues la otra persona es la que chupa. So think, guys, about an experience. What happened with you?
Me, teacher.
Tell me.
Bueno, in one occasion when I was a high school student, I have a teacher of math, but he is very, very rude, okay? So in one occasion, I couldn't make a final exam, but I di el examen in the holidays, and my grade was 0.5. And but I solved the matter, but I don't need the grades because I don't study. But the teacher go for all the students say, this student has 0.5. This student is a bad student. So when we are arrived the task of the teacher, he saw the grades of me, but he have a. He is surprised because I have a good notes and I don't need the final exam. And this
So even he didn't know that that was your test, right?
Yes.
Él ni idea que era tu prueba.
O sea, más que nada fue porque pensaba que me iba a quedar y por eso fue diciendo, este tiene 0.5 y después vio las notas y ya había pasado.
Este Daniel, vago. So yes, yes, sometimes that happens, right? We have to deal with some rude people. A veces nos toca lidiar con gente que es un poco grosera, ¿no? So, and maybe at work, maybe at the school, like Daniel told us. Good. So what about you? What do you or what can you share with us? Lizeth, ¿qué puedes compartirnos? Any experience with someone else rude?
Yes, teacher. Is about... It's about the experience of my mother. The last week I had to accompany my mother to the bank because she can read or write and write. And she had to fill out some papers, but me out of the bank because only person could enter. And I explained the situation, but they said they were going to help my mother, but this person this person didn't help my mother correctly. Y my mother's feel sad.
Yes, I know. That should have been a problem. Maybe she felt frustrated, right? Because she wanted to be with someone she knows, to help her. Mm-hmm. Sí, a veces uno se siente como que más en confianza con alguien para que le ayude en situaciones como estas. Y generalmente en el banco no es que sean la mata de la cordialidad a veces. So, yes.
Eso, teacher.
Thank you for sharing, Lizette. Let's listen to the last situation. Please, can you help me with your experience with someone who has been rude? Let me see. Marjorie, no le echo a hablar. Have you been with someone rude, Marjorie?
Yes, teacher. When the last week I went to the market,
mm-hmm.
the saleswoman was very rude because I was to buy strawberries, but she wanted me to buy her many more things, and I don't.
Okay, and you
want.
Uh-huh, you didn't want. So she was rude with you. That sometimes happened. I remember when I went also to the market and I was buying some pork meat. Estaba comprando carne de cerdo. Y claro, la señora me dijo, si me compro esto, le vendo esto. And I was like, then I don't buy you. No. Sí, entonces no le compro. Porque sí, a veces la gente suele ser grosera cuando vende, ¿no? So here in Ecuador, we are not so good at selling stuff. No somos tan buenos en atención al cliente. Okay, guys. Thank you so much for sharing your experiences with us. Now we're moving to the grammar part that we will check today. Sí, vamos a ver un poco del contenido. Sorry, de la clase de hoy. So you're going to read three different emails, guys. Me van a ayudar leyendo tres emails diferentes. And you're going to tell me what are they about? ¿Sí? ¿De qué se trata cada uno de estos emails? And also try to see if they are formal or maybe informal emails. Okay, so the first one, what is the email about? And the second one, is this email formal or informal? Okay. Lo primero, reconocer si, de qué se trata el mail. Y lo segundo, ver si es formal o informal. So, please guys, help me reading this one. Now I'm going to ask to... esta vez le voy a pedir que me ayude leyendo, por favor. Let me see. Edgar, can you help me reading this email, please?
Yes. Hi, Jad and Brenda. A quick message to say we're really sorry. We had to leave early last Saturday. The dinner was terrific and we had a great time. It's a shame the woman looking after the kid feel unwell and we have to go home. You must come round to our house for dinner. We'll be in touch soon. All the best, don't.
Exactly. So, what are this email about? De qué se trata este email? What are they talking about? Pay attention to these three words, guys. Here we have the word terrific. The dinner was terrific. What do you think it means? ¿Qué significará esta frase? La cena estuvo... Hello. ¿Qué significa la palabra terrific, guys? En este
caso. Fantástica.
Fantástica, perfecto. Muy bien, Daniel. Sería, la cena estuvo maravillosa, fantástica, increíble, fenomenal. Todos los adjetivos buenos podrían entrar dentro de esta palabra terrific, ¿no? The dinner was terrific. Estuvo una bestia la de buena, ¿no? La cena en este caso. So, the dinner was terrific. It's a shame. ¿Cuánto ocupan esta frase? ¿Qué significa? It's a shame.
¿Es una lástima o es una pena?
Perfecto. Es una lástima, es una pena que la persona que estaba cuidando de nuestros hijos no se hubiese sentido bien. Y hayamos tenido que regresar a la casa, ¿no? You must come around our house. Tú debes... ¿Qué era come around? Acuérdense de este phrasal verb.
Venir.
Exacto. Venir, ¿no es cierto? Tú debes venir a nuestra casa para cenar. We'll be in touch soon. Estaremos en contacto pronto. Entonces, ¿de qué se trata? Aquí hay una mezcla, ¿no?, de información. What is he doing? We have two things. First, here we have it's a shame, ¿no es cierto? Tenemos un it's a shame, es una pena. Cuando ustedes dicen, es una pena que no haya podido ir a tu invitación. What are you doing? ¿Qué están haciendo? ¿Están invitando o están disculpándose?
Disculpándose.
Mm-hmm. You are making an apology, right? And by the way, when you use come around, this time you are making an invitation. ¿Sí? Cuando ustedes dicen, ustedes deberían venir a nuestra casa y bla, 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 bla. Ya están invitando, ¿verdad? You are making an invitation. So here we have an email where you are making an apology and you're also inviting someone to your house. Sí, nos estamos disculpando y también invitando a la vez. What do you think? Is this a formal email or maybe an informal email?
Informal.
Okay, could be an informal. We have hi. Okay, we have some contractions. We're going to see what kind of email is this. Let's check the next email, guys. Vamos al siguiente email. This time I'm going to ask to, I think, Jody is going to help me reading. The second email.
Dear Miss Pamel, thank you for your email of 22 May about the delivery problem you had. We are writing to apologize about the long delivery time you experienced. Recently, we have had a few problems and we are working hard to reduce these times for our We hope you will shop with us again. So we are offering you a 10% discount on the next book you buy from us. This is our way of saying sorry about the problems you have had. You're sincerely hate huge customer service manager.
Exactly. So what is this? What kind of email is this?
Formal.
Mm-hmm. This is a formal email. Right here we have dear, yours sincerely. So yes, this is a formal email. Aquí tenemos ya un mail formal. So in this kind of email, look at this, they are writing to apologize. Y están escribiendo para disculparse. So let's check the last email we have so you can tell me what is this about, okay? So Leandro, can you help me reading the last email, please?
Yes, teacher. Dear Celia, I am greeting to let you know that we need to rearrange tomorrow meeting. I am very sorry about that. Unfortunately, Gary has just asked me to prepare a report on the staff we have here in our London office. He says it's urgent. Could we meet next Monday afternoon instead? I'm very sorry to pad our meeting off, but I have to finish this report by end of the day tomorrow. Let me know if next Monday afternoon is possible for you. Best wishes, Kathy.
Exactly. Thank you so much, Leandro. So is this a formal or an informal email, guys?
Informal.
Okay, kind of seems like an informal email. Let's see. We were checking or we were discussing at the beginning of the lesson the difference between some formal and informal emails, right? Here we have, in your books, you also have this chart, which shows you some of the phrases you use in an informal email. In a formal email, that were the ones that we just checked at the beginning of the class. And in the middle of both, we have a semi-formal language or a semi-formal email. Sí, tenemos un mail semi-formal, con un lenguaje semi-formal. Es decir, que va a tomar partes del uno y partes del otro. Como podemos ver aquí en el saludo, tenemos un saludo formal, ¿no? Dear Celia, I'm writing to let you know. Este I'm writing to let you know es como una fórmula ya un poco más formal. Sí, pero tenemos un saludo mucho más relajado, perdón, una despedida mucho más relajada. No, aquí decimos best wishes, ¿no? Mis mejores deseos. Y también, si nos damos cuenta, tenemos el uso de ciertas contracciones. So, it's kind of an informal and a formal mail together. No tenemos aquí una mezcla de ambos, de lenguaje informal y también de un lenguaje un poco más formal. So, at the beginning you can see the greeting. Sí, los saludos tenemos en la primera línea. In the second line, we have the reason we are writing the email, right? ¿Por qué razón estamos enviando ese mail? Al inicio o en el primer párrafo vamos a introducir la razón por la que escribimos ese mail. Then we have the apology, ¿no? Porque si se dieron cuenta, every single mail of the three mails that we read. Sí, de los mails que nosotros leímos eran o se trataban sobre pedir disculpas. So, Here we have how can we start writing an apology, ¿no? Aquí hay frases que nos permiten disculparnos. We are really sorry. I am very sorry. Or we are writing to apologize, right? And at the end, we have the sign off. Sí, ya para finalizar, nos quedan únicamente las despedidas. So, this is a very short chart of formal, semi-formal, and here we have three different examples. Aquí tenemos tres ejemplos diferentes. Sí, how to write a formal, how to write a semi-formal, and how to write an informal email. Como pueden ver, los saludos van cambiando, ¿no? First we have dear, then we have hi, and hey, right? The same happens with the sign off. Lo mismo sucede con ya cuando uno se despide, ¿no? In a formal way, we have sincerely. In a semi-formal, see you soon. And when you are being very informal, you say just bye. Okay. So, according to this, ¿sí? De acuerdo con esto, esta diferencia entre mails formales e informales, you're going to work on something, guys. Vamos a trabajar en algo. Pay attention. And let me share the link with you. So, what we're going to do now is a writing task. Okay, vamos a hacer un ejercicio de writing. What would you have to do? What do you think? ¿Qué creen que van a tener que hacer?
A letter.
A letter or an email, exactly. So, do you remember the ladies we were listening at the beginning of the lesson? ¿Se acuerdan de los chicos que escuchábamos los problemas al inicio? There was Tim, Vicky, and Rebecca, right? We're going to do something. You're going to help me writing an email to Rebecca. Sí, vamos a escribirle un mail a Rebecca, a la chica del inicio. And we're going to reply to her invitation. Sí, vamos a responder a su invitación. ¿Se acuerdan que ella había invitado gente y nadie le respondió? Bueno, vamos a ser nosotros los que le vamos a responder. Como que Rebecca nos hubiera invitado a su fiesta. ¿Ok? So, what are we going to do? We're going to write an apology email. Vamos a hacer un email informal. Remember, this is going to be informal. And you're going to think about how you can say sorry. ¿Sí? Vamos a tratar de incluir esta información en el mail. Think about how you can say sorry. ¿Cómo pueden ustedes disculparse con Rebecca por no ir a la fiesta? Think of an explanation for what you did. ¿Sí? ¿Cómo le van a decir que están apenados? Que por favor les disculpe. ¿Cuál va a ser su explicación? Es decir, ¿por qué no pudieron responder a tiempo la carta? ¿Por qué no pudieron asistir a la fiesta? ¿Sí? And offer, make an offer or a suggestion to make things better. ¿Sí? Y en este caso, pues, van a tener que hacer una oferta o una sugerencia, ¿sí? Para mejorar las cosas. Más o menos como en el primer email que ustedes leyeron. Sí, que les decía, lo siento mucho porque la niñera se enfermó y tuvimos que regresar, pero todo estuvo excelente. Sí, ¿por qué no vienes a cenar a nuestra casa? ¿No? Estaban haciendo una oferta en ese mail. Algo parecido vamos a hacer en este email to Rebecca. ¿Ok? So think about these three topics and write a short informal email to Rebecca explaining you why you couldn't go and you couldn't reply to her invitation. We're going to do so here on Padlet, so I'm going to share with you the link. Igual en este Padlet ustedes tienen la información, la misma que les acabo de compartir, la tienen en justo esta parte de la descripción, ¿ok? In the description of the activity. So, let me share the link with you and you can start with this classwork, okay?